name is Steve. This is my shop. My daughter and I have decided to join the other 10 billion people out there and start us a YouTube page. I'm retired, and I'll show you on my shop later, but I just piddle around here. This is what I do now, and I'm a piddler. And I like to work on vehicles. I'm not a mechanic by any means. Google helps me diagnose the problem, and YouTube teaches me how to fix it. But my daughter, she works full-time. My youngest daughter, I have two. My youngest daughter, she works full-time, but she's taking on what people call a side hustle. I never really liked that term. But basically that's what it is, where she rescues furniture. It's furniture that she'll pick up at garage sales, or she'll see on different media that people are trying to sell, estate sales, whatever. And she's a reconditioner, and she does a very good job of that. And I'm going to try to help her out as much as I can. Now that I'm retired, I have the time. So we decided to get us a GoPro, or get us a camera, and start filming some of the stuff we're doing. And this is day one. And one thing I've learned already is you can't record it if you don't start the camera. So I've been working around in my shop, trying to get some stuff. And you'll see, again, I'll give you a little tour of my shop for too much longer. You'll see how packed it is. We're going to have to do something about that. But it, trying to get ready to help her do more of the stuff so I can cut more lumber for her, reduce morality. And I have all the tools. Right now, I have an old grinder that I've never used and don't care about ever using it. I don't know how old it is. It's just my brother inherited somebody and he gave it to me. So I don't even trust the grinding wheels on it. You can see, maybe you can see. Look like it's been on there a long time. So I'm going to try to turn that into a buffer. Because she tries to recondition a lot of the hardware. She might not use the same hardware on the piece of furniture that she buys. She may change it out with a different piece, or a different style, or color, or material, metal material. And sometimes she does want to use it because it'll come with some pieces come with some very unique pulls, door pulls, door pulls. So she's been eating some chemicals and she'll soak it in and try to recondition it. And she's had some luck doing that, but I think we'd be better off on a lot of the hardware, the hinges, the pulls, the handles, I'll learn how to do some buffer. Now, I'm going to try to adapt this grinder to a buffer. I have a small buffing wheel. I don't know anything about buffing. I got to learn how to do that too. Again, that's where YouTube comes in. Somehow YouTube's going to teach me how to buff. And I'm going to try to adapt that to this. I had the other side, the other rock pulled off the other side, so I realized maybe I'll affect the camera. Maybe this, day one has to start somewhere. So we're going to start now. So this is where I'm at in this little project. I got this done on the other side. I've got all these screws here loose, except one. There's always one. Always, always one. Always. And I might find a way to get it out. Continue to try with the filter. That'll be worth it. I have a couple other options. I have a ease I can put to a grill, stick it in there, catch hold of the screw and back it out. I have that. And I also have a grinder. I use a grinder necessary. It takes music, makes much noise, takes spots there, or metal. It's just gonna
I've been speaking on a little bit. I do have some
locker loose up there. Try to get it to loosen up and come off. I'm trying to keep as much oil off the table as I can, but I want to clean it up. And maybe spray paint. Plan B. All right, we're gonna go to plan C. Because I could not find that ease out to pull those screws out. We're gonna do that. Not unusual for me to have a little trouble finding. I get too much stuff in my shop. And I try to put them in places where I know I'll find them. Then I can't find them. I can't remember where I put them. They got too much. So, hide your ears. I'm back. The fire is. Now this thing here, I said, I don't know a lot about it. I know it's recorded to it. Label on the front. I'll try to show you later. I'll show you that later. Commercial grade. And it could very well be, don't you? You know. You buy a lot of tools now that are may have a brand name on them. And they may claim commercial grade. Many times they're not. The brands don't have to sell them. Place so I can find it again. Let's see if we can get the wheel off. I think this might be left hand thread for the way it stands, but I'm not sure. We'll see. This is fit. This is right there. Just put this side. That is. Oh no. The camper is. You know how I knew that? YouTube. Person on here that's done this, converted these into a buffer. Like I'm going to do. And they showed me how to do it. Well, they showed me how to do it. He's been there so long, but the washer wasn't long enough, so. Yeah. may not be anything wrong with these other than year. No, I don't trust them. I live this long. I don't want something like this. But I do know that I'm going to do a second buffer wheel. I do know that the wheel I have, I can't use these. Put the buffer wheel on there. It doesn't need enough shaft. They'll work fine. It'll work fine. It might not work fine on this side. Other side I put it on is fine. It's good. This side here is going to be, oh, I know it's good. Einstein. You know what I mean? I'm not a professional. Like I said, I put these back together. I put them in a pile. Do that when I want them in the future. I might find it. Maybe. Put a fly, it's bound to turn me to make love in my arm, I guess. Oh, another one. I can't get this down. I'm probably going to combine that. Screw those back together. Y'all got flies for y'all? You don't? Can I send you something? Look at that. You gotta get on the first name basis when you fly. Hey, any of y'all got one of those little guns that put salt in and shoot flies? Ain't that the greatest thing in the world? I'll sit here in the evening after a long, hard day of work and have a cold drink, adult beverage, and shoot flies with a gun that shoots off. That's the greatest thing in the world. I gave comments to my wife, like, where all the salt come from? I play for the grandkids. Dude, I think I come on. You made me break out the cat-like reflexes any minute. Get that. All right. I got them screws back in for safety. I was going to show you earlier, I'll show you now. It'll fit. But see, it won't fit with these. That's just pushing it. This here on the inside, pushing it out too far. I won't be able to get another one. I need a washer on here. Probably about this side. On both sides. The thin washer always going to be. Just so I can snow you up for that boat. This is my plan. That right there. Now, one last thing I've got to think about is I don't have to think about it. I got to do something about it. Switch on the front. I don't know if y'all can see this. the switch says 240 volt, 20 amp. Now the motor tag on it, the identification tag, tells y'all about the motor. It doesn't say anything about 230 volt, 20 amp. It's 105, 115 volt, 7.5 amp. So that leads me to believe this isn't the original on and off switch. And, but it does show the RPM as a two-speed RPM. 1450 or 2870. That's right. 1450 or 2875, I believe it says. So it no longer has, I might be able to wire it up. I'd be able to open it up and see how they wired it. And they may have wired it up on the fast speed. I might be able to just change some wires around and put them on low speed. I'll have to see. But I'll tell you what I'm going to do. This is, as I said earlier, this is my first time ever to do anything like this. So I'm going to stop here. I got about 20 minutes on here. And so I can see how I've done and see how kind of improvements I need to make for you guys. I hope to do this pretty regularly. And again, I got to get in my head when I'm doing something to invite you guys in and let y'all see it. Those who are interested, of course. And I tried not to bore you. And I think you'll enjoy our videos. Like I said, we're just two normal people trying to make a living and enjoy life. And I'll see y'all again soon. Thank you.